So first of all, let's look at your work and finances. We have the Two of Pentacles and we have the Eight of Swords. I feel a lot of you who are in a situation where you are jointly linked up with another person, there are major problems and potentially arguments as to who is earning what and who is spending what. One person seems to me to be a little bit frivolous and the other person has a very, very strong grip on money. So financial, compromise is going to be of the utmost importance for you for this month. Knowing, I see like a lot of you are planning something and there's a lot of tiny little expenditures here and there coming out. And a lot of you might even be saving up with a significant other for a major trip if you're thinking about travel, because the Two of Pentacles is also juggling two sources of finances, okay? So two joint accounts, like two accounts merging together, two houses, two people with different income, one person earning a lot more, one person earning a lot less, and then both parties are asked to contribute the same amount, which doesn't seem to me to be fair. There's a lot of balance, there's a lot of like fine-tuning, there's a lot of like trying to work something out so that you both can reach an equilibrium. It's majorly important for this month. I feel there has been some type of imbalances that needs to be restored. Otherwise, it can cause a lot of discord in the future. So this is a month in which you and another person are being severely tested, I would say. How you balance each other out, how you both can compromise, what's fair, what's not, who is doing what, and if the other person is like resentful that they're shouldering the weight of the relationship. So I definitely feel what I'm getting is, I feel like for those of you who are in committed relationships, especially if you feel that you are the one that is doing all the work, and likewise, if your partner feels that they're the ones doing all the work, like planning all the dates, paying for everything, if they're like the ones that is the practical person in the relationship, I do see these imbalances are like little cracks in the foundation of the relationship. It needs to be examined and it needs to really be looked at, okay? I see other people as well, other couples or even other people. You could be single as well. What I'm sensing is I see you struggling and I see like somebody looking on but not really sure how to help. So I feel like there might be some confusion, some muddled, confusing energy coming through. And you're trying to get through it and you might be looking to vent to somebody, but I feel like there's that disconnect between that emotional support that you're getting from them and the advice that they're giving you. It might not seem appropriate for your case, okay? So it is best for you to, once again, if you need to take a step back and right yourself emotionally, it would be good for you. With the Eight of Swords here coming on so early in the month, this is a situation where we feel very, very stuck. We're waiting on something. We're waiting on information because, you know, she's blindfolded. She doesn't have her bearings. She doesn't know what's going on in her environment. There's a lot of uncertainty at work here. This might have been residual energy coming in from June, but I definitely feel that you're in a very uncomfortable space. Financially, you're in a very uncomfortable space right now and you're not really sure how to proceed, how to move ahead. A lot of you might be juggling two jobs or waiting on a job. You're still at one job. You're waiting on communication for another job and you might not be able to get that until the end of this month, okay? But hang in there. I do feel the situation will get better by the end of the month. You have some very good cards coming through. In terms of your communication, we do have the Princess of Swords, the Page of Swords, and the Three of Pentacles. So the Three of Pentacles is greatly about collaborating with another person, working together as a unit, and learning to compromise, okay? This is basically the apprentice. Somebody is teaching other people how to do something, or they are working in a capacity where they're giving advice, they're giving counsel so that somebody else can improve upon their work. So this is constructive criticism. You might be in a position where you are dealing with an air sign, Aquarius, Gemini, and Libra. They might tell you how you can do something a little bit better. And there might be a little bit of a conflict of interest coming here. A lot of you might be trying to build a foundation with an air sign. And I sense almost as if you both are very, very different. Earth and air are very practical people, both of them. And I feel like both very stubborn as well. And both think that they're always right. So I feel like there might be a little bit of creative differences. There might be a conflict of interest coming through. You both will be able to harmonize this situation, okay? So I don't see any major problems coming in for you. But it is, they're giving you actually very good advice, and you likewise are giving them very good advice. So it's just a matter of meeting each other halfway and trying to find a way to agree on something so that you both can birth or build up something of value together, okay? So don't work at cross purposes with one another. The other thing I'm sensing is the other person might come in kind of like, I know exactly everything that I'm doing. So, take it with a grain of salt. They're just very easily excited. I don't feel that they're pompous or arrogant, but the way they come in, it seems as if they're just excited to start things, and they might seem a little bit like arrogant, but I don't feel that's their intention, okay? The page energy is easily excitable, and they can multitask very, very well. A lot of you might not be good at multitasking, so I feel like this is a person that would be a good asset on your team, okay? So I feel like you might have to pick team members, you might have to like get to pick and choose who you are working with, and you might shy away from this person, but they're coming in knocking on your door, and I feel that they have a lot to offer because I feel like you both complement each other very well. In terms of your financial situation too, there might be a situation where you are consulting other people, consulting people for financial advice, consulting them on investment opportunities, new jobs, looking for new jobs as well, or doing some type of a training, seminar. You might be training other people. You might be working with people who are a little bit younger than yourself, and you're going to have to be very, very patient. You naturally are. But I do sense somebody might test your knowledge to make sure you're up to snuff before they really take your word at face value, okay? So there's a little bit of you have to like put yourself in the spotlight in order to persuade other people for this month. Now, home life. We do have the Four of Wands and the Nine of Cups. So I see major, major celebration happening in the home life and environment, okay? First of all, I do see the Four of Wands here is a very stable home life. It also indicates marriage. It also indicates proposal, expanding the household, people moving in, people moving out. I do see people moving in rather than out. So a lot of you could be birthing, new children, expanding the family unit, doing construction on the home, adding an extra room, for example. So I feel like new energy is coming into the household and a lot of celebrations to be had. A lot of you are possibly thinking about engagements and marriages as well. Buying new property is greatly indicated with this cluster, like these two cards in conjunction with one another. The Nine of Cups is the wish card, and the Four of Wands is the marriage stability card. So in conjunction together, you might be attending weddings where you might be drinking a lot, socializing a lot, mingling a lot, okay? I do feel for a small minority of you, you are planning your wedding. You are with a significant other. I feel once again that whole balancing act. One person is very, very extravagant. The other person might want a small affair. So there is, like a small engagement. So there is some type of a compromise that needs to be had. One person might want to go all out. The other person might want to be a little bit more conservative. So I feel like either way, you are going to be able to reach a compromise. This is a very, very good combination for taking a relationship to the next level, for solidifying the home environment, having social functions at home, and even for those of you who are working at a cubicle, you might get that office that you've dreamed of, okay? So I feel like some type of a solidification in terms of having structure brought back into your life that can come in a physical structure or that can come in more of an emotional structure where you are being able to like incorporate something or to build something up. So a lot of you, I do sense engagement. I do see marriages, weddings, attending weddings, being the guest of honor, speaking taking out, like making a toast at a wedding or a major celebration that brings family and community together. I see family more with this card rather than, you know, strangers and acquaintances and professional contacts. I mentioned earlier, towards the end of the month, you might have to draw back your energy. We do have the Hermit card as well as the Seven of Cups, okay? I feel like a lot of you have many, many social functions. And by the end of the month, you might be in a situation where you are kind of, you might feel under the weather. You might feel like emotionally a little bit overwhelmed from having so many social functions to attend and so much compromise that you need to attend. So I feel like if you are constantly surrounding yourself with another person, I keep seeing there's this person that's like joined to you by the hips, it seems. And I don't feel like they're doing it on purpose. I feel like you're just spending a lot of time with another person. And I feel you getting a little bit burned out by the end of the month, okay? I just keep getting this person circulating around you. So you have to draw back your energy by the end of this month and, you know, spend some alone time to catch up on work or to even take care of your own responsibilities. I feel like you might be scattering your new, your energies with other people. So it's important to pull back and, you know, get some alone time, get some downtime. I see your energies being scattered to with many, many projects and many, many people. So, you know, pull it back in and take care of things on the practical end. The Seven of Cups here indicates, you know, a lot of choices, a lot of options that are opening up for you. And I feel what's happening here is they're telling me, you know, do some preliminary research in order for you to arrive at the right answers. Okay, so I feel like if you are choosing a venue, for example, do the research, look at reviews, customer reviews, client reviews. If you are looking for like a new property or even a new apartment, once again, there's a lot of research that needs to be done to narrow down these options and to make sure you're making the best possible choice for yourself and your significant other, okay? So I do sense like a lot of research. What you see is not what you get. All that glitter is not gold. So be mindful about the veneer of things. Make sure things are structurally sound. Make sure that everything is firmly planted on a good foundation, okay? So doing that preliminary prep work is going to be required of you. I do sense though, Taurus, one of the main things that they do want to emphasize here is that I see this person, I see you like, you know, running around with this person, a very, very close person to you. I don't know for others, some of you it might be like a wingman, you're going out a lot and this is like your wingman. Others of you, it might be like your significant other and you're like very smitten by each other. It could be new love, or it could be somebody that you're making all these major decisions with, but they're constantly around you. And it's basically saying that when you're constantly with the other person, you don't really know what you want, okay? You might compromise and say that's what you want, and you might feel that's what you want, but you're not going to be able to know which direction you need to head in or what really stirs your passion until you take a step back and figure out, you know, draw back your energy and figure out like what you want, because I feel like there's a lot of energy interference. The other person around you, I feel like they're highly excitable. They're very fun, exciting, and you know, it's they seem to me like they're of a different element than you. They work from the heart and they might do things prematurely. And I feel like because you're an earth sign, you're naturally attracted to someone who's a little bit more spontaneous, who is a little bit more like you know, who grab life by the horn. So you're fascinated by this person, but I feel like the things that they like might not jive well with what you like, but in the whirlwind of it all, you might think that's what you want. So draw back your energy, figure out what you want, and don't compromise so much that you lose yourself, okay? That's the only danger I'm feeling here, okay? And be careful about squandering money. Be a little bit more conservative with spending. Don't squander your hard-earned money, because I feel like there might be some buyer's remorse coming through by the end of the month. Now, in terms of your advice, what I do feel here is this is a really, really busy month for you on the work front. So don't put anything that needs to be done on the back burner, because I feel you inundating yourself by the end of the month with a lot of options and a lot of work that you need to catch up on. This is not a good situation to get yourself into, okay? Like carrying all those those wands up those stairs, up that tower, and it seems like an ancient building, so it probably doesn't have an elevator. So it doesn't seem like a smart move. So don't procrastinate on anything, okay? A lot of you are physically moving from one location to the next with all of your belongings. So I feel, once again, donating a lot of the things. If you, like, my rule of thumb is, if you haven't touched something in like 3 months, and, you know, assuming that you live in a temperate climate and your wardrobe doesn't change much from one season to the next, if you haven't touched something in 3 months, it's probably a good idea to get rid of it, okay? So I feel like it could help you greatly to start downsizing by the end, but by the beginning of the month, rather than taking everything with you. Now, earth signs tend to, you know, you're very practical, so you don't have a lot of stuff, but there are some out there that can be like a little bit of a pack rat, and you have sentimental value sentiments tied up with belongings and, you know, like luxurious items too. And I feel like it might be a good time for you to see what you can part with so that you're not strapped down with so much baggage and so much belongings, okay? I feel that what's happening here is a lot of you are transitioning to a water sign. So this could potentially be a love interest, or it could be like somebody that you have a very strong emotional connection with, okay? Somebody is helping you out greatly and offering you very solid advice. This is a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Somebody new, very nurturing, very loving, coming into your midst. So while you're struggling with this, I do sense that there is another person in the picture for you that is giving you a lot of emotional support, okay? So for others of you who might have had financial difficulties, I do feel financial help coming through from a water sign, okay? This is the financial windfall card. So I'm seeing here that if you if you are in a situation where you feel like, I really can't do this, hire experts, hire consultants, hire people that can, that have the expertise to make the process a lot easier and smoother for you. They know what they're doing. So it's okay to dish out a little bit of money in order to get solid, sound advice from experts, because I don't feel you're going to be strapped for cash, okay? I do see a financial windfall coming through, and it's saying here that, you know, possibly in the time of financial windfall coming through, if you've been waiting for it in June, it's coming through from the 20. So I'm seeing like the 21st and the 21st of July to the 27th. They keep popping up. I feel like that's a very, very significant time frame or week for a lot of you, because I feel financial windfall coming and a lot of support coming in, communication coming in too for those of you who have been waiting. So if you've been waiting on a bid for a house, I do see something being returned to you, like official documents that are very favorable, okay?